Welcome back to the game. We just arrived in Tularean Forest. Most of the map here is just one large elven city. We'll take the horseshoes immediately. There's usually two or three somewhere very close to the stable. We should get quite a lot of important things here. One good thing about traveling with a paid service is that you don't spend any food. Ah, great druid. Advancement as a druid is simple. You must visit the three ancient temples to nature we erected centuries ago and pray at their center. They are in Tatalia, Evenmorn Island, and Avli, and look like circles of stone with an altar of water in their centers. Where exactly I will not say, but exploring the islands above them is part of the process. When you have visited all three circles, return to me to detail your experience. So, just click three spots around the world and that's it. What could be more simple than that? Do we have feather fall? Reminds me, yes we do. That's it prevents you from taking damage when you're falling from too high. It's very good at some point. I just get reminded of it because I'm thinking about what we have to do to get the druid promotion quest done. And we'll have to enter some very dangerous territories. And I recall some of the being on a cliffs like that, so what we'll do is probably run to them, use them and run over the cliff. So we need the featherfall. Although, since this is a no loading game, at least unless the game crashes or something, we might not do that. It's very risky, and we can't really afford the risk. Perception Master and Grandmaster is in danger. You will have to go through all these buildings to get quests. Did the trainers? Oldest tree. The Tularean forest is so old that it has developed a mind of a sort. The forest is vaguely aware of who walks through it, but only one part of the forest can communicate with people. That's the oldest tree. If you want to have a very long and slow conversation, it will be happy to oblige. Look for it on an island to the southeast of the forest. It's larger than the rest of the trees. You can't miss it. Go take a look what this is. It's an obelisk. Those are ores. Kurgar lace ore, that's a good one. Field isn't that great. Field, but Kurgar lace is. You can make very good items from it already. We'll take the field too. We can sell items we don't actually tend to use. It's sort of a gambling, and these are the chips you use. One chip and you get a random item. It's not really gambling in the sense because you don't lose anything. You just lose a chip, gambling chip, but you don't lose any money. You need to try usually quite a lot before you get anything worthwhile. It's not that you'll get terrible items. If you have good ore, you'll get a good item. The problem is, it's very likely not that useful for you. For example, there's only one. The categories, I think, are items, weapons, armor. There might be a fourth one. But you get the idea. Very few large categories, so if your guys use leather armor, for example, it's well, that's probably the easiest to get. But if you want a plate armor, you might have to find half a dozen to a dozen great ore to get that. And it doesn't work in a way that you need great ore to get plate armor. It means the ore quality impacts what tier of an item you get. So even crappy ore can produce plate armors, but it'll be just the crappiest plate armor you can get. Same, it'll produce the crappiest chain armor, crappiest leather armor, and so on. So good ore will always produce a good ore item. Likely it'll also have a, if it's good enough, it also has a strong enchantment. So even if it's not good to you, it's a great item. Erudine is probably next after the Kurgar ore. And after that, there's something else. I don't recall what it is. It's pretty much guaranteed to get a great item with a great enchantment, but that's very rare. Shield pedestal. What does shield do? Don't see. There's some kind of building here. Probably an altar. If you visit these at the right time of the month of the year, you'll get a permanent boost to something. Plus 10 to water, fire, and air resistant. Permanent. Yeah. We were very lucky to pick this place to come first. Because if we would have come here later, the month would have most likely changed and we wouldn't have cut in anything. So that's very nice. Air magic expert. And nothing else of interest. I actually visit all these houses. Maybe I didn't visit this one. Either way, we'll next go to the actual city. Well, that has to be the stairs. Guards. Elven guards. They aren't too bad. Might have to fight them. At least some of them. But we don't want to start.
The council is in session.
I'm about to hunt revenants. Some kind of an undead creature. What's a sage? Increase the identify item and identify monster skills. Interested? Chimney sweep. That's a
greetings.
Lot. Yeah, 20-point bonus to luck statistic for everyone. Earthmatic Master. Circle of Stone. Three circles of stones were built by the druids long ago. Since hearing of their locations, ruins ascension attempts for would-be great druids, I can only give you a general clue. All are in the open, unhidden and bare. All are distant from settlements. To tell you more would spoil your ascension. Uh, Spirit Magic Grandmaster. Secret passage, yeah, that's the secret passage to the castle.
How may we help you?
Dodging would probably be a good skill for everyone.
Walk in the
No, it isn't. You get it when you're not wearing armor. You have to be able to train it to Grandmaster level to use it with leather armor, so it's only good for our monk, and we're not gonna invest in it until we can train it to Grandmaster level. We should get a nice group of quests here, not sure when we can finish them. That's the bank.
Your gold is safe with us.
Your gold is safe with us. Yeah, that doesn't exactly inspire confidence.
Your gold is safe with us.
Merchant expert, merchant master. We'll explore this area first because it's a dead end.
Fine elfish weapons.
Spear. Spear might be a good weapon for an archer.
Come in. How may I help you?
Practice makes perfect.
Welcome, travelers.
We're not gonna play Archomage yet. Reason being that it's a quest to play it in all the taverns, and I don't want to play it at all until I have the quest. That's why it's easier for me to keep track of where I've been and where not. Leather Grandmaster. Bow expert. At forest. While ago I saw some men come to the Tularean forest at night with axes and torches, following some sort of map. When they left they were laughing and happy. It looked like they were carrying a big green rock. My brother says they were a band of mercenaries from Tatalia. Anyway, the next day was when the forest went mad. It's too dangerous to go there now. Okay. Mercenaries from Tatalia took something out of this forest. And the forest went mad. Can we get... we could get a bow expert. No, we can't. This is one of those situations where I'm inclined to use up a couple of horseshoes. Because there's no telling when we'll come. Yeah, 2,000 gold. Oh man. Spearmaster. Yeah, I do want to see. You must know the skill before you can... I just wanted to see if we can ever train it. We can, it's better than swordsmanship. Chain expert. We could become a chain expert. I don't think we will. We're pretty much broke now. Heavy. Missing people. People have been disappearing recently. Not just one or two, but several every day. They go to bed at night, and the next day they aren't seen and their houses are empty. I certainly wish someone would find out what is happening. But Evenmorn Island. Evenmorn Island isn't lost so much as hard to get to. It is surrounded by treacherous reefs, sandbars and whirlpools and sharks. If it's dangerous, the island is surrounded by it. There are only one or two safe ways in, and the map for those ways was stolen by pirates during the chaos of the recent wars. They probably still have the map in their caves. That's a hindrance for many quests. It's really not that easy to get to. I think it's even needed for the clerical quest. So we need to tackle a lot of things. Need to keep on moving, not to get bogged down in these. Dagger expert, dagger master quest. During the wars between the temples of the sun and moon, three statuettes were stolen from the shrines in the Bracada Desert, Tatalia and Avli. I represent a group of druids that want these shrines back to their original form. It is critical for their worship. To this end, I'm offering a substantial reward for anyone that will find the statuettes and place them on the shrines. That's something very unlikely to complete for a long time. We don't know the location, don't have access to them, and we don't have a single statue or any idea where to find them. So it's by luck if we find them all. More trainer locations. Hunter. Think you can improve? I have a test for you. A hunter needs to understand the woods, and a hunter needs to be as skilled with magic as with a blade. The best teacher for that are the fairies. There's a fairy mound in northern Avli. Figure out how to get in, and the fairies will grant magic to the genuine rangers among you, meaning that they will be promoted to hunter status. The rest of you will be honorary hunters. This is probably the easiest promotion quest. Okay, all we really need to do is get to Avli and we're set.
Looking for something special?
Someone really needs to get the repair item. Quest. I hear you folk are the new Lord of Harmondale, eh? Perhaps you could do me a large favor and help yourselves in the process. To the north in Avli lies the hall under the hill, the domain of the Fairy King. He owes me a debt from a previous service of mine, and I would like to collect it. Unfortunately, the fairies in the hall and the tricks they play on frighten me to death. If you would deliver this letter to the Fairy King and return what he gives you to me, I'd be very grateful. You would also have the chance to meet the Fairy King for yourself.
Yeah, it's a good quest since we have to go there anyway to get the promotion for the rangers. We can buy Tularean wood here. We can sell it in Harmondale, so that's it's not worth a lot. Sell Griffin feathers. That's likely from Erathia. If we are coming here and going to Harmondale, we might try to make a little bit of extra money. Alchemy expert. Very cheap to upgrade. Reef maps. The boat captains would be happy to take any paying fare to Evenmorn Island, but they don't have proper maps. There's no way anyone is going to risk their ship in the reefs around the island unless they have the map. Yeah, it's a nice hammock in there. Disarm trap expert. Yeah, we need to be promoted to initiate to gain the skill. You know that. I think we got the most of it. There's shops there, nothing more. It's very hard to walk in a straight line because the main view screen is not in the center. So where you're used to looking is the wrong place. You'll always walk a little to the left or a little to the right.
I suppose I should just stare at the arrow. Line it up and then just press forward. We need to go to Abli. But let's check where the transport services go.
Need a ride?
We're not going back to Harmondale. If this doesn't go to Abli, we'll go by foot. It's onto the north, and we'll do some exploration of this map at the same time.
Welcome aboard!
What's the time? We have a few hours left. We'll try to do a little bit of exploration here. We don't have much time though. The reason is I'll be left with 6 gold coins at this point if I go by boat, and that's not really acceptable. It's too little. The spells I cast are Bless and Heroism. Bless is an accuracy boost. Heroism is a damage boost for melee weapons. We'll mainly be doing range combat here, but want the option to go close range to be available. Yeah, that's the mad forest. Stay mad.
Ow.
I think that's some kind of an earth magic attack.
Ow. Ah,
what a scratch.
You'll get precious jewels from these. Or at least there's a chance you'll get.
That kinda hurt a little.
And you don't want to stand still for too long. They do give you some trouble.
Ow!
Ow!
Ah, what a scream.
Ow!
Ah, what a scratch.
Try to heal a little bit.
Ah, what a scratch. Ah, what a scratch.
Ow! Ow!
We'll go to close range combat because it's much more... can deal much more damage that way. Usually you don't get anything from the trees, but there's a chance to get a precious jewel. Gemstone. Okay, what's the time? Still have some time. Play. Quick save. Well, we have 759 gold. Is that gold? Yes, it is. As you can clearly see, there are 135 coins there. That's good eyesight. I have to say, don't compete with that. And this looks odd. Yeah, this must be the secret entrance. Where are those? Elvis Toadstool. Mercury. I don't think I want to go there. We'll go. Is that money? Yes, it is. It's money. We're abandoning it. We have to make it to the boat in a very short time. And I do mean short. It's we have 43 minutes, and we have 42. So it's basically more of a like we have seconds, 40 seconds in time to reach the dock, or we can't go there. There's no. There's a boat, and the staples function according to our schedule, so there's no guarantee that the next day has any way to reach Avalade through the services. It's simply faster to use the services, and time isn't totally irrelevant in this. It's not like you have a strict time limit or anything, so you don't have to worry about that, but it does matter somewhat.
Welcome aboard!
Okay, we never should buy the travel with the monk either. It just costs more.
Raise the anchor and set sail!
It's the same time of day though. So we'll try to... No, we'll try to visit the fairies. Faerie King. We can't really do much anything now, anyway. It shouldn't be a long dungeon, if I recall correctly. That's why it is one of the easiest. Doesn't look like much, but getting in isn't easy. Careful not to stray from the path.
What do you think we'll find?
I think we'll find a Faerie King. The little king bows, welcome to my realm, mortals. Few attain the door, and for that I commend thee. But now that you stand at the threshold of Faerie, know that few return that dare to enter. We'll ask about the hunter. Yeah. Come to my door looking for magic. Thee've always had it if thee knew where to look. Some I tell this to, and they still can't see it, though it be plain as the nose on their face. Those amongst thee that are simple rangers are now hunters, and those who aren't are but honorary unhunters. Clever the ones who can knock on my door. It pipes. So, Johan be wanting the fairy pipes, eh? I can't say I'm surprised. He wouldn't come here himself, the coward. The pipes will cost you, though, all your food. Of course, I've got some delightful food down below, should thee be wanting to restock your packs. Yeah, bastard took all our food. That's not a big deal, though. We basically completed two quests at the same time now.
Doesn't even hurt.
Yeah, we took some damage. Increased effect of all air spells. Faerie ring. Very, very powerful item. Increased effect means it'll boost your spell skill according to the skill level you already have. So we have 3. It'll provide us with what? +1. So probably 50% bonus rounded downward. So when we get Air's magic level 4, we'll get bonus of 2. The music seems kind of loud, but it's already the lowest on it can be. If I take it any lower, it'll just turn off. Yeah, but it's not too much of a problem. Again, music doesn't constantly play in this game. It just plays and then it's silence. So it shouldn't be too much of a problem if it's a bit loud. It's not like it'll last. We can hear enemies. That's why I'm buffing. And there are enemies. Where are you? Some kind of snakes. Yeah, dragonflies. Nothing to worry about, really.
Ow! 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 Ow!
That was too easy.
Ow!
Ow!
We got a key. Very key. Okay. That's an apple. Okay. You eat the apple, you get increased food pack. Food increases in your packs. Yes, these aren't anything of importance. There should be more food here. One apple isn't exactly a refill of our packs. What's that?
That's rubbish.
That is rubbish. Not gonna even bother taking it with us. Any incoming enemies, dragonflies, nothing to worry about.
Ah, what a scratch.
Yeah, there's still more. We have 3 days worth of food. Anything below 5 though is sort of a too little. And I'll zoom out the map. I want to... the general view is more valuable than the closed up view. Just searching for a secret doors. It's a fairy dungeon anyway. This seems to be a secret door. Ooh. A little bit of money and a blade mail of some kind.
Oh, that's something else.
Yes, it is, but we don't have the skills to wear it. No item.
Oh, what a piece of junk. Oh, what a piece of junk.
Yep, some strong opinions there.
Ow!
Ow!
It doesn't even hurt. It doesn't even hurt.
Still more.
That's rubbish.
That is rubbish. Where are the enemies now? We can clearly hear them, we can clearly sense. This is something's... yeah, we can clearly see that there's something here. But if it would open... you want to pay attention, well you probably can, but there's a little text right between the main view screen and the character portraits, there's a text. If there's something of interest, it'll usually show up a text there. If there's nothing, it'll show up nothing. So what we'll need is to find some there, a door. I can't see it, but I can see the text. So that's a good way to find secret doors. You don't have to go clicking around like a madman. You just have to be at attention. Every time you see something flicker there, that's something. That has to be the fairy key. It doesn't seem to be anything else here, so we'll proceed.
It doesn't even hurt.
Ah, what a scratch.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
That was too easy.
And these were the last ones. A lot of gold. We're financially doing just fine again. We can afford to do some training. Don't have to worry about who drinks from it. Refreshing, refreshing, refreshing. It's not a safe business to drink from wells. I know there's some things that have random effects. They can turn you into stone or eradicate your body or something like that. So it's definitely not a safe thing to do.
Ow,
what
a
scratch! Oops, sorry about that.
Almost died. I'll try to get everyone back to green before even charging it again. The trap is there no more, so we don't have to worry about that. Not really worth it, but not a bad thing either. Do we get out of here? I just walk all the way back. What a nice bonus place. A little bit of gold, a little bit of food. We'll have to buy food though, so no point in picking it up. It'll still cost the same to refill our packs. But a few quests done. Our first promotion quest done. Got a powerful magical item. We are back with a reasonable level of wealth. Do we get out of here? Okay. And it's night. We'll find the... Dark looks a little bit odd. Ooh, and it's not the only thing that looks a little bit odd. Graphical messing up. That's again because of the recording. You can use a much better system on playing these games than you can actually use to record them. If you don't use the software rendering options, you'll get a constant flickering when you record. So it's occasional odd graphic or constant flickering during the recording, and I can deal with the occasional oddity. Constant flickering is extremely annoying. It'll make any video totally unwatchable.
Welcome, travelers. Our meals are second to none.
Guess we could buy the perception skills. The guys who don't have them. It really is a good skill to have on everyone. We'll rent a room for the
have
night.
Have a pleasant evening!
And we'll start to explore Avli with a little more attention to detail.